Janusz was frowning at his laptop. Janusz was always frowning at his laptop these days. The man looked uncannily handsome, even with his brow all furrowed over a bit of admin. Charity was honestly amazed at how much her brother had lucked out when a routine call-out had turned out to be from an astonishingly attractive Polish bisexual, with a ghost pirate in his kitchen and a thing for gangly, awkward British men. And here was Charity, cuter than a button, and still with absolutely no need for a double bedroom of her own. Bit unfair, frankly. Usually she'd tell herself that it was fine. She was still young and she still had time to find a Janusz of her own. But, you know, the world was sort of on the brink of ending. "So, we should really work on clearing this job constipation," said Janusz. He meant the work backlog. Neither Daryl nor Charity corrected him. "There's a cluster near Exeter," Janusz continued. "Maybe we can go down there, see how many we can fix." Charity groaned. "Not the southwest. It takes ages to get to, and we have to drive past Stonehenge." Daryl shuddered. Charity knew that bringing up the henge would get him on side. It was, according to her clairvoyant mother and brother, absolutely heaving with the dead. "We don't have to drive past Stonehenge," sighed Janusz, with the soft weariness of an utterly non-psychic man who actually really liked Stonehenge, but knew he would never see it again because his husband was absolutely terrified of the place. "But we probably should drive, so... Charity, me and Daryl were wondering if maybe you could message your mum. We've had trouble matching schedules with the other half of the family lately, and we think maybe..." "Maybe it's because Mum's still sulking that we moved out,"